गुड आफ्टरनून चिल्ड्रन,
गुड आफ्टरनून,
गुड आफ्टरनून. सिट डाउन एंड डोंट सिंग, यू पुट मी टू स्लीप. ऑल राइट चिल्ड्रन, रिमेम्बर लास्ट टाइम वी हैड डन अबाउट बुद्धा.
यस
सर. यस. एंड अलोंग विद बुद्धा देयर वाज अनदर नेम आई हैड टेकन. व्हाट वाज हिज नेम?
महावीर.
महावीर. व्हिच रिलीजन डिड ही स्टार्ट?
जैनिज्म.
ही स्टार्टेड अ रिलीजन कॉल्ड
Jainism.
All right. Okay. What are the followers of Mahavir called?
Jains.
Do we have Jains amongst us?
Yes.
Who? You are?
Yes.
Wonderful. Very good. All right. So Mahavir. If I remember, there's three people out over there. Wonderful. Very good. All right. Now. Have you taken out Vivatnas?
Yes.
All right. Okay. Just like Buddha said there are four noble truths, Mahavir also. See, Jainism and Buddhism both were reformed. It started as reform to the Buddhism, to Hinduism. Both Buddhism and Jainism started as reform movements to Hinduism, to Brahmanic order. If you remember, I told you that. Pay attention. Pay attention. I want the class to pay attention to what I say. Alright, so Jainism, in Jainism we find that Mahavir also spoke of three truths or three ratna as we call. What are the three ratnas? Let's see what they are. What are the three, the four noble truths, the three ratnas? Well, he's finding out. We'll see what the three ratnas of Mahavir were. Remember, I had also said that Buddhism became famous in the northern part of the country and Jainism in the southern part of the country. Why? Why?
Auntie, because Auntie Mahavira did his Auntie sermons in the southern part and...
Mahavira did not go. Mahavira also preached in the northern part. Actually, what had happened is, after both Mahavir and Buddha had left their bodies, you know, there was a famine. And because many kings in the northern part of the country had converted either to Buddhism or they had made Buddhism their state religion, so the Jain monks, they crossed the Vindhyas and they went to the south, to the southern part of the country, where they were protected, they were given patronage by the southern kings. That is the reason why we find Buddhism flourishing in the northern part of the country and Jainism in the southern part of the country. Right? Now, did we find three ratnas? All right. So what are the three ratnas? We'll just see what the three ratnas are. Why is it so slow? So, who was Mahavir? He was born in a Lichavi clan. Right? He was a Kshatriya prince and he was born in a Lichavi clan. Right? And at the age of 30, he renounced the world and he went out in search of truth. Okay? Did he find it? No.
Auntie is very slow.
Yeah. Very, very slow, huh?
Auntie, he was a member of the Janakika clan and he was a Lichavi prince.
That is what I said. Lichavi is a clan and a prince also. Okay. So we'll just see the three ratnas. Now, please understand the difference between Buddhism. Now, Mahavir, why did Mahavir had many followers? Because again, he spoke of
equality
and he spoke in the
democracy.
And he spoke in the common language of the people, which is Prakrit. Therefore, people could understand what he was saying, and therefore, there were many, many followers that he had. Right? Now, what is the difference between Jainism and Buddhism? Mahavir talked of, you know, very, very strict meditation, hard penance, as we call it. Did you understand? Whereas Buddha talked of a middle path. He talked of a neither very strict nor very soft, not very easy, right? Whereas Mahavir talked of very strict disciplines. Yeah.
Buddha, Dharma and Sangha.
Buddha, Dharma and Sangha. Alright. So, we have to understand what Buddha, Dharma and Sangha are after contact. Right? Okay. Now, so, this is the difference between Buddhism and Jainism. That Buddha talked of middle path, whereas Jainism talked of very strict penance. Right? Now, after Mahavir died, Jainism got divided into two sects. The two sects are Shvetambaras and Digambaras. The Shvetambaras, as they are called, they wear white clothes, and the Digambaras actually do not wear any clothes. Buddhism got divided into two sects, which is called Mahayana and Hinayana. Hinayana. The greater wheel, the lesser wheel. The Mahayanas, they worship idols of Buddha. Here, they, the Hinayana sect of Buddhism, they started following or practicing Buddhism as was preached by the Buddha. Did you understand?
Yes, sir.
The difference between the two? All of you? Class, did you understand the difference between the two?
Yes, sir. Yes,
alright, so here the three ratnas were Buddha, as is given in the Buddha, Sangha and Dharma. Alright, okay. Now, we have to understand how was this message of Buddha and Mahavira carried forward. Somebody mentioned in the beginning that there were monks and nuns. Monks and nuns who went from place to place preaching the teachings of both Mahavir as well as Buddha. The monks and the nuns, they begged, so they were called bhikkhus and bhikkhunis. Bhiksha dete the. They used to live a life on alms that was given by the people. So there were days when they would get lots of things, and there were days when they got just a very little thing to have. Whatever they had, they distributed amongst themselves and they ate. Hence, they were known as bhikkhus and they were known as bhikkhunis. Now, before they had started living in a sangha, sangha is what? It is an organization. Sangha is what? It's an organization. Right? In this organization, these monks and the nuns lived. They were separate for the men and separate for the women, but they lived in that sangha and they used to learn the Buddhist texts and they would go around preaching it to the people. Am I clear? But before the sanghas came into existence, can we have the Karli caves? Can you see this natural cave, children? These caves are in Karle,
Maharashtra.
As does it's in Karle, Maharashtra. These are natural caves. Alright? This was the place where these bhikkhus and the bhikkhunis lived before the sanghas were, or the organizations came into being. Did you understand?
Yes, sir. Yes.
All of you? Alright? Okay. Now, can I rub all of this, children?
Yes, sir.
And can we see a chaitya? Go back. Alright. Can you see this room, children? This hall? Can you see this hall?
Yes, sir.
This is called a chaitya. This is called a chaitya. What was the purpose of this? The Buddhist monks and nuns, they worshipped over here. Did you understand? Can you find this is a typical chaitya, which means this was a huge hall with pillars on either side and the statue of a small stupa at one end. Bhikkhus and the bhikkhunis would sit facing the stupa and they would meditate over here and worship the Buddha. Chaityas. Then the place, the natural caves that we saw, do you remember Karle, the natural caves? Those were called the viharas. Vihar in Hindi is a pravachi of ghar, griha, right? Vihar. So those were called the viharas. And the third architecture that we have is, can you see the Sachi stupa? Was the stupa that was built in remembrance of the Buddha. His hair, parts of the tooth, nails, hair were all kept under the stupa, and this huge stupa was built. This is of course the picture of the Sachi stupa. Sachi stupa, it is near Bhopal. Was that?
Excuse me,
Andy. Yes.
Andy, the bhikkhus and bhikkhunis for Jainism as well as Buddhism.
Yes. They're known as bhikkhus and bhikkhunis. Okay? Mm-hmm. Alright. So these were the architecture that is connected with, yes, Buddhism.
Aren't we like once I went to places where Buddhists have worshipped Buddha. So like when I went to Gaya, over there they told that the ashes of Buddha, the ashes named here, and to these things were divided into five parts and sent into five
different places. Yes. Huh? Alright. So, these were the chaitya, the vihar and the stupa are all falls into architecture of Buddhism. Am I clear? Now, again, you know, in the 6th century BC to 6th century, can I rub this?
Yes.
Have you put this down?
Yes.
All. Again, as I say, the 6th century BCE and the 6th century AD were interesting times, is because have you heard of this?
Yes, Auntie.
What is this?
Auntie, where students Auntie take teachings?
What is this? What is this?
Auntie, a book, Auntie, is
not one book, there are many books.
Yeah.
Huh.
There are books in which teachings and new thoughts are written.
Remember new thoughts and new ideas, I said? Yes. Remember I started off by saying Buddhism and Jainism were challenging the Brahmanical order? So there were many flaws in the Brahmanical order which were questioned by people. And all that has been compiled, all those commentaries have been compiled in books which are called the Upanishads. It meant that the disciple would go to the teacher, sit near the teacher, would carry on a conversation or a dialogue with the teacher. And all of that was compiled in a book called the Upanishad.
It means the conversation of the teacher.
Correct, the dialogues between them. So the Vedas were there, whatever the conversations happened between the student and the teacher was all compiled in the Upanishad. Am I clear?
Yes.
Alright. Another interesting idea that had come. So that brings us to the, and of course along with that, you may have heard about a great grammarian called Panini. Sanskrit grammar was writing books over here during this period of time. So there are many, many things that had taken, that new thoughts, new ideologies were taking shape during this period.
Excuse me. In the book, it's written according to the Jains, Mahavira is the last of the
Tirthankaras. Spiritual guides, I told you, spiritual guides. So it is believed amongst the Jains that before Mahavir, there were 23 other Tirthankaras. Okay. Anything else that you want to ask me, children? That brings us to the close of this chapter. And we have finished Buddhism and Jainism with their ideologies. Yes.
And they have found that in this chapter only you asked the name of Gautam Buddha's son.
Auntie, he was Rahul.
Yes, his name was Rahul.
Rahul.
His name was Rahul. Rahul. How can you remember the name of his son?
Auntie, Rahul Gandhi.
by the Congress leader Rahul Gandhi. Not Gandhi, but Rahul is the name. So you can remember the name of Buddha's son. His name was
Congress
chief. Congress chief, his name was Rahul. Any other questions?
Auntie,
yes.
Auntie, you saved me. Karma.
Karma. आपके कर्म अच्छे हैं तो अच्छा, आपका कर्म बुरा है तो आप बुरे. बुद्धा फिलोसफी एक्चुअली, ही सेड दैट नोबडी कैन बी जज्ड अ गुड पर्सन बाय द शियर फैक्ट दैट इज बॉर्न टू अ गुड फैमिली, हाई प्लेस फैमिली, सोशल ऑर्डर और अ लोन. एनी अदर क्वेश्चन चिल्ड्रन? नो. यू अंडरस्टूड द चैप्टर थरली? Yes.
Yes.
Now, if I give you a test, you will be able to do.
Yes. Yes.
All right. Quickly.
What are penances?
Penance, tapasya.
Tapasya.
So remember, I said Mahavir believed in very strict penance, meditation, or living a very hard, difficult life, torturing yourself. And actually, the 12 years of penance that Mahavir had done, he had turned into a skeleton. Do you understand? So Buddha did not believe in that. He said you should have a moderation of both. You should be soft at the same time, hard. You can't trouble yourself so much. Yes?
Is there only one stupa or there are many?
There are many stupas. Now they were very interesting. Have you seen the stupa, the Saji stupa? What is the shape? It's a semicircular in shape. Can you find that? It's semicircular in shape. Right? And Buddha had a very close disciple by the name of Ananda. What was the name of his disciple? Ananda. Now, Ananda was the person, he questioned Buddha of why women cannot be allowed to enter the Sangha. Buddha actually had not agreed on women entering the Sangha, right? Turning a nun. But Ananda argued that if they have the will and the desire, they can be allowed. So Ananda is one. Ananda was also asked Buddha that, you know, we are thinking of constructing something after the death of the scholars or your disciples. So how should it be? Have you seen a begging bowl, children?
Yes.
It's a circular thing. It's a small thing. A circular thing. Chota sa hota hai na? So immediately, what should the structure be? Because Buddha was asked by Ananda, what should the structure of the stupa be like? So Buddha, what did he do? He just turned the begging bowl upside down. This is the Bharut stupa, the Sati stupa. This is the Bharut stupa, the place in, this is in Sarnath where Buddha had given his
first
sermon, right? Dharma Chakra Pravartan. He started moving the wheel of law, and hence this incident in Buddhism is known as Dharma Chakra Pravartan. What is it called?
Dharma Chakra Pravartan.
Yes, somebody was asking me a question. Yes.
Auntie, this stupa that was in Sarna, auntie, I was told that it was first just a low level, like this high, a platform only. But when Ashoka came to Sarna, he built it above till there.
Now if you go back to the Sati stupa, just go back to the Sati stupa.
Excuse me, auntie.
Ji.
What was the full name of auntie ji, Mahavira?
Vardhaman Mahavir. Alright. Now if you see the Sachi Stupa, children, can you see this? This is the Sachi Stupa. Can you see the semicircular dome? This thing, it's the back of the bowl. That's it. Different from the Bharut Stupa. Again, the Sachi Stupa was built by Ashok, but it was enlarged to its present form by the Sunga dynasty. Later on, you do this later on. Am I clear? Alright. Any other question? Yes.
In Mahavir, the meaning is like, sorry, the Jains mean the conqueror, is right from the Virginia, which is conqueror. And here the teachings say that we should support non-violence.
This conquering is not going out and conquering lands.
Achha.
It's conquering yourself.
So, auntie, Veer also means like the battle and the very angry person.
Veer is a brave person. Is a Veer. So, the person who has conquered his self is actually a Jaina. Jinnah. Did you understand? Alright. The conqueror of the self. Here the conquering does not mean going out and conquering lands. Okay? Alright. Any other questions? No? Alright. Thank you, children.
Thank you.
Amen.